Hello Gemini, welcome to your 2021, first 2021, I should rather say, a general reading for the month of January 2022. Happy New Year! How bloody awesome! On the 2nd of January, we have a new moon, which means the moon is not illuminated, since the moon really is all about our emotions. You may start the year off feeling a bit down and thinking, oh, not sure where I'm going here, right? Which is, again, all because of the stars, if that makes sense. But something really bloody awesome is happening on the 4th of January, right? While the moon now needs from the 2nd to the 17th or whatever it is, right? 14 and a half days before the moon is full again. On the 4th of January, the Earth is the closest to the Sun, and the Sun is what gives you your energy. Your star sign, Gemini, is also your Sun sign, because the Sun was in when you were born, literally makes you your Sun sign, therefore your star sign. So, therefore, the first week of January alone gives us all a massive energy boost. So because on the 4th of January, the Earth, the blue planet we live on, is literally the closest to the Sun, which is called the perihelion, make it count, right? There is an energy boost that comes in, make it count, work it for you. Let's jump right in here. We're looking at your January 2022, and we're dividing it slightly. So first we're looking at the overall energy for the month of January 2022. It's a weird thing to say 2022 when you have said 2021 for a year. January 2022, we're looking at your overall energy first before we then go into your emotional core. Let's have a look what's going on with your emotions and maybe love and all that kind of stuff. And then finally we look at opportunities as to present themselves to you in January of 2022. So it's slightly divided because I find it makes it easier to understand. Let's get the first cards in for the overall energy for the months of January 2022. So I already mentioned that on the 4th of January, an energy boost is coming in. And it is really important because we have, these are just symbolism, obviously, we have what is called the moon in Capricorn and the moon in Aquarius. And ultimately, what the guides are saying to you as the overall energy, which means how you probably should carry yourself in January, is to realize that you should put aside emotional concerns. Just because you may think, oh, I'm not so sure where I'm going here and how I'm feeling. If you are in a situation where you feel you don't want to be in, then don't be in it, right? Warts and all. It's when it comes to the universe, it's always rather simple. Because we are part of evolution, and therefore, as far as the universe is concerned, we're still children, we're still learning. But we do come from our animal kin. We're just, you know, on the branch of apes, and now we're here humans. Ultimately, what you would not find in the animal kingdom, and we're so keen to not being called animals by others, because it has a negative reputation almost, which it shouldn't have, because animals are bloody awesome. I personally take animals before people anytime. Anyway, we are part of something that has changed and shifted over a long, long time. What you wouldn't find in the animal kingdom is an animal going, don't like it here, but I stay anyway. Right? It makes no sense. Since everything is a teacher, why can animals not be your teacher, right? So that's what I'm getting. And since we're having the moon in Capricorn, it's important to, obviously, another animal guide here. Ultimately, what the guides are saying is, in order for you to achieve a new beginning, you need to understand that you need to overwrite when you're not feeling well about stuff. If you feel the pushing through could get you somewhere, but only to a certain extent, right? If you really feel that you're not in the right place, you shouldn't be and shouldn't stay there. Always, that's what I always do, and that's what I always say to my clients. Would you advise your best friend to go to the place you work at? Would you advise your best friend to live the life you live? If the answer is not necessarily, then something is clearly off, right? So that's message number one. And then you have the moon in Aquarius. And Aquarius is a giver, right? The cup bearer, for want of a better word. But the cup that I'm being given here is not only full, it's overflowing. And what that means is that it is really time to celebrate what you have achieved. This is the time for you to pat yourself on the back and acknowledge your awesomeness rather than saying, oh, it's all shit and nothing really works, because that's too easy and that's also counterproductive, right? Okay, obviously, I know it's not as easily said than done. I myself suffer from mental health, and I can talk myself out of the best opportunities when my energy is a little low, right? But do as I say, not as I do, is what comes to mind here, right? So that was just the overall energy for the months ahead. January 2022 doesn't flow yet. The word 2022 after saying 2021 for a year. But here we are in the month of January. Let's see what we got for your emotional core. And it is interesting because I have these color cards, as I call them, or maybe as they're called, I don't know. And I always shuffle them well. And yet what we have been given for your emotional area is indigo and purple. Very similar colors indeed. Colors that on the prism will support one another. So there's, before we look into anything, first message here, therefore, is that when it comes to your emotions, which means when it comes to letting stuff go, or when it comes to opening up to love and maybe new relationships, you are fully protected. Now, in indigo, the idea is to understand your vision, right? If that makes sense. Indigo is also the color of the third eye. So the idea is to not only improve your vision by cleansing your energy, but also realizing that what I get from improving your vision is literally you saying, I can already see what's coming to me, right? And I can already say to the universe, thank you for this, even if it's not here yet. If you speak as though you already have it, it'll come. So that's what I'm getting for you with regards to love. And I think what I'm hearing the strongest is for you to say to yourself, or maybe even say it out loud, have it as a note on the refrigerator, I am good enough. Because somehow that seems to be missing from your vocabulary. You're not often, according to the energy that I'm getting here, you're not often saying, I'm awesome. And I have that mantra for the last 30 years. I wake up in the morning and go like, I'm awesome. And it cracks me up. And also when I start, you know, cracking up every morning and laughing my head off, it hires my energy. So I invite you to do the same. It's very easy. You wake up in the morning, first thing you do is like, I'm awesome, it's out ego, and you're gonna be fine. So we just talked about improving your vision, which is your indigo. And this is about manifesting what you really want to have and what you really want to happen. But purple goes deeper, if that makes sense, being the crown chakra's color. Because what they're asking you to do is to also literally get a better mental clarity of where you're going. What I'm hearing is, to say that in a less shrouded in mystery kind of way, is for you to have a clear idea where it is you want to go. So maybe that's a good idea here for you in January to literally write down a list of things that you want to have. What I'm not hearing is for you to make a pro and con list. Don't write down that doesn't work and that doesn't work and that doesn't work, because your energy is not all that high on its own in January, which is why we were saying earlier that you have the that you ought to use the power of the Earth being close to the Sun on the 4th of January to get a bit of a boost, right? But if you say, okay, I reflected enough on bloody 2021, right? What is it I really want? And then literally write it out. You know, write like, I want this, and I would like to have this, and I want this, right? Without getting greedy. You know, Gene Simmons of Kiss? I always quote him. Poor guy. He's probably not a poor guy. But anyway, he, in an interview years ago, he said to someone, they asked him, what have you learned being in the rock music business for 40 years or whatever? And it was around the time when he turned 70. And anyway, he said, dream big. And I quite like that. Not a big fan of the way Gene Simmons conducts himself sometimes, and he can a bit be egotistical, but that stuck with me. And so obviously that comes up here, right? So yeah, maybe it's time I listen to a bit of metal, right? So that's everything I got for your emotions. Literally start writing down what you would like to see happening, if that makes sense, right? Because it makes it easier for you to manifest. Now, finally, we're looking at your opportunities for the month of January, and that's, wow, they only give me one card. Right, okay. Opportunities, you have green as a card. So green also means, you know, spinach and the likes. ultimately, the message for you is, in order for new opportunities to come your way, you have to first revitalize your metabolism, you have to revitalize your nervous system. My feeling is, for you in January 2022, that you started or ended 2021 rather, very likely rather low-ish, with a lot of stuff that probably hasn't happened. And what the guides are saying to you is, don't carry that shit with you into 2022. You make it all better by literally claiming it. That's what needs to happen. But somehow, apparently, when you have green as the only card for your opportunities, it literally means that you may already be affected physically by the happenings of your life. And they're asking you to look after yourself, nurture your body, have more greens, obviously green. And also, green is everything here, the heart chakra. And remember, where the heart chakra is the sternum. And the sternum is where rejection sits, right? So allow yourself to let that go, right? If anyone didn't want you, any situation doesn't want you, right? Other opportunities will come your way. And it's good that you're not egotistical and say, delos, right? Which is a very common phrase that people use, because sometimes a loss can be felt deeply, and it's all about acknowledging it. Right, that was all we got for the first month of 2022. This was your January 2022 general reading. Please, please, please like, subscribe, and share. And if you like my work, you can also buy me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. See you next time.